Hello all, hope all of you are doing well. I wanted to do this quick video to address a specific issue of the US Capitol protests. If you want to kind of get more of my complete thoughts, experience, analysis of the event, please watch my full length video that I did a couple days ago. But I wanted to make a statement about the police injuries, the violence against the police, and the death of Officer Sicknick. Some of those facts, including his death, he was still alive when I did the previous video. So since additional facts have come out and his passing, I wanted to come on and do an explicit video here. I condemn the death of Officer Sicknick. I want to come out full-heartedly condemnation and make that 100% clear unequivocally. According to the facts that have been reported, he was hit over the head with a fire extinguisher. There is no excuse for that. No excuse. No excuse whatsoever. I share in my full-length video kind of the thoughts of most of the crowd that we wanted a peaceful occupation of the Capitol grounds, and that, you know, if we could get into the Capitol peacefully, nonviolently, that we would do that, similar to how the anti-Kavanaugh protesters occupied the Senate office building during his confirmation hearings. That was more what we had envisioned, to disrupt the proceedings, which protest groups and various ideologies have done that for decades, if not centuries. That's what we were looking at, is more of a disruption. I saw a shocking video that CNN published that gave me a different angle of what I had seen outside. So I believe I described in my previous video of how patriots for a few hours were trying to shove their way through this one entrance. You know, people had gone through some other entrances, and I've published videos that I have found of that, you know, and shared those on my Instagram and Facebook feeds. But this kind of main front entrance type thing, at least it felt like the front entrance for those of us occupying the outside of the Capitol. You know, at first it was just shoving, you know, and patriots were trying to push their way through. And that's one thing. Pushing is one thing, you know. I wasn't one of the ones pushing. I don't know if I would have done that. But there's a big difference between pushing and shoving your way in and turning to violence. And what really concerned me, because I was able to observe kind of the outside of it from the outside, when I saw people bringing implements, you know, 2x4s and metal poles, and hitting police officers with it. And I could catch kind of a glimpse of it from the outside. And periodically, these protesters would be able to push the police back, and then the police would deploy tear gas, and, you know, the protesters would come out sputtering. Other people would take their place. And it was kind of a give and take, you know, back and forth, as they would push the police back into this hallway. And the police were really doing an incredible sacrificial job trying to hold off those protesters. They were doing their job. And, you know, sometimes the protesters get the best of police officers. I saw probably 10 riot shields handed out that they grabbed from the police, etc. So this video, I see, you know, hitting, grabbing, very violent. It's no wonder that there were 50 police officers injured. Now, I understand there's patriots who are injured and such. People will bring that up. You know, there are 4 patriots who died, possibly needlessly, possibly because of police overreaction, some would say. I'm not going to enter into that argument right now, because the purpose of this video is I want to explicitly condemn the violence against the police officers, the killing of Officer Sicknick, you know, where it appears he died because of blunt force trauma to the head. That grieves me. He was a military veteran. He served our country honorably. And his dream was to be a police officer. And it deeply grieves me that he died that way. That death did not need to happen. Some of the other acts of violence against the police officers that I witnessed personally, that I've seen in the video, again, tactics that I do not condone. Many of them tactics that I outright condemn. And I wanted to make this very clear, very plain, and make a standalone video saying that I wholeheartedly condemn the violence against police officers. And, you know, we can debate about other tactics when it comes to protest, are you like Gandhi and MLK, or do you mind, or is a little bit of pushing and shoving applicable? You know, those are different. That's a different discussion. But beating police officers over the head with 2x4s, spraying chemical irritants into their faces after you pull off their masks, hitting them over the head with a fire extinguisher. No. No. And I know some of those people who are carrying out those acts, many of them are not representative of the Patriot movement or the conservative movement at all. Definitely not the conservative movement. Definitely not the MAGA movement as a whole. Most MAGA conservative activists have condemned that kind of violence. And many of them, there were many anti-government types who were there. Some of them not even Trump supporters, just anti-government, right-wing anarchist types. And many of those are the ones who are carrying out that kind of violence. They've been looking for an excuse to fight the feds, you know, for years, you know, some of them since, you know, Ruby Ridge and all of that. So they didn't have the right tactics, and they didn't even have the right motives. So I just wanted to come on here and make that very painfully clear. Please watch my full length video. And I'm going to do probably a couple other short videos like this, to address certain topics that I might have not fleshed out fully in the previous video. God bless all of you.